down next door.
Conference now, aren't they?
Yeah.
área, né?
Yeah.
shooter. Questing just brings in a 2-3 zone. Pass goes inside to Heisinger, but deflected, still controlled by Hitchcock Schuler. Noel works the perimeter, comes back up to the top of the key. Off to the right side, Noel gives it off on the wing. Copeland. Copeland goes high post Heisinger, feeds down low. That's a little too high for Brandon Starr. Out of bounds, and Westington Springs gets the ball off the turnover. Spartans will try to keep things going here as Tyrell Thibodeau comes off to the right side, Bridgman. Bridgman, the freshman, goes baseline, keep underneath the basket, will kick it out. Thibodeau for three off the left wing, in front of the rim, no good. Kick it in for the rim for Hitchcock Schuler, and it's Jerry Portland. Patriots set it up, bounce pass comes off the left side, Stahl back up top, Noel running the point in the corner. Spencer Hull, all goes inside, Hitchcock Schuler came out of the pass. He's being bothered there by a double team. Springs with the ball off the turnover. Thibodeau into the paint. That's Tyrell. Lobs it up on the baseline. Clemenson back outside. Richmond will take the three. It's good. 5 points and it's 5-0. Westington Springs. Quick start for the Spartans. Backcourt. Stahl will get it across the timeline. Now flips it up ahead. Copeland. Copeland hands it off to Noel at the top of the key. Noel. It's off left side, a play will catch there between Noel and Stahl. Noel ripping up left side, all has it on the wing. Now off to the high post, kick out, there's the open shot for three, and in by Jerry Copeland. 3 points shot in for Hitchcock Schuler. There on the board, it's 5-3, Westington Springs. Get it all into the front court. For Hitchcock Schuler. There's two seniors on the roster for Westington Springs, so a neither team has a lot of upperclassmen. They throw no good for Morris. We'll get one more shot here. 5:20 to go in the first quarter. 7-3. Westington Springs on top early. Game 2, 2A1 Conference Boys Basketball Tournament. Good crowd here at James Valley Christian School. Second free throw, Noel, no good. Bridgman with the board, right? And the freshman's done everything here in the early part of this game for Westington Springs. Tyrell Thibodeau gives up top. Now goes to Tate. Tate coming off the left side. Cut off. There goes the fadeaway shot. Front of the rim, no good. Rebound, Noel squeezes in there through the loose ball. Left side, Tyrell Stahl. He'll go down the lane. Boy, a nice try. Missed the shot. Rebound, Noel. He'll take the rim. He cuts to the Noel with the bucket. Lead cut to 2 with 4:50 to go in the first quarter. Out to the right side, Bridgman comes up top, Thibodeau. And the Tyrell goes to Tate. Tate on the left wing, and Tate will stay with the Westington Springs in. Spartans will inbound it near the corner of the court on their baseline. Pass comes in, left side, Bridgman goes inside, turn around the shot. Off the glass, and off for 2 be Hitchcock two-layer ball. 4-point lead Spartans here with 4:25 to go first quarter. Pass goes baseline Stahl back up top Noel. Noel free throw line stop. Puts up the 10-footer. Good. Looking at it. And Noel with the bucket is second of the game. 9-7. Westington Springs. Bridgman coming up the left side of the floor. Free throw line. Cross court it goes to Tate. Cut it all for three. No good. Rebound and Noel can't handle it. It's a save in. And possession will go to Pitch count two there for the Patriots. In possession, we have our first sub of the game in. In fact, two subs coming in. In for Washington Springs, Alex Time, a 5'9 junior. Also on the floor for the Spartans, Max Lewis, a 6'4 junior. Pass comes in the corner hole as they work against the press. Noel spins, gets away from the double team. Into the front court, ball catch away from the corner. And Zach Clemenson will still be Patriot possession on their baseline. 9-7 lead for Westington Springs with 3:55 to go in the first quarter. Hitchcock Tuler will go right on the baseline stalling. Double team, has to get back out. There's the fadeaway shot, Copeland right side, might have been partially blocked here. Balls it, will have a jump ball in the battle through the rebound. And possession out goes to Westington Springs. So early start here, both teams really going at it at a pretty eager pace. 9-7 the lead for Washington Springs. That's all that's keep with it. Bates gets to see his defender up on the line and gets the perfect hit of his first bucket. Well, the team shooting the ball fairly well here in the early going. It's 11-7 Washington Springs. Back court, a little pitchy hit. Hopefully, he's going to the ball. Keeps control of the ball. Get a smart thing there. They're going to put his ball hand up on the ball. So he needs to carry. Ball is double team. Now finds Renee Stallable. Baseline Heisinger goes with the reverse layup. Lost it on the way up. Stall with the rebound. He'll put it up on the block. And the rebound comes down to Washington Springs. So the Spartans really battling with the big guys for Hitchcock Tuler. Pass to push it by Noble, but controlled by Bridgman. Fakes, leans in. 12-footer. Baseline goes with it. Gets his own board. Knocks it out. And reset here. There's a long three for Clemenson. No good. Rebound on the block. Comes Goldberg down to the near end. Pulls up 15-footer. No good. We got a pretty hefty pace going here in the early going. 11-7, though, the lead for Westington Springs at 2:40 to go in the first quarter. Up top, the ball goes to Hine. Hine up the top of the key, left side. Tate to it all, cross court back to Hine. That goes inside to Linus. Linus trying to get a shot off, and Hine gets called for the 3-second violation. He's pivoting, but had been in the lane the whole time. Just a matter of time before the 3-second violation is called. We have our first Patriot subs in the game now is coming in for Hitchcock Tuler, Tyler Burton, a 5'11 senior, and Nathan Peterson, a 6'4 sophomore. Hitchcock Tuler working against the little trap there as Washington Springs settles back in their zone, pass in the middle, knocked away from Peterson. Ball will stay with Hitchcock Tuler, far end of the floor with 2:11 to go here in the first quarter. After a hectic start there, scoring-wise, things have slowed down here. We've been stuck at 11-7 for a while. Hole for three, deep in the corner. No good. Ball tipped out. Going to be controlled by Stahl. We'll go back up. Hard to believe. Can't get out to do it. Aaron Stahl keeps the bucket. 11-9. The lead back down to 2 in favor of Washington Springs. Andy Johnson in the game. 5'10 freshman for the Spartans. Dribble down to the right side. Tyrell Tethadon back here. Ball's kicked as he tried to host it up down low to Linus. Possession will stay with Westington Springs. Minute 47 to go in the first quarter. 11-9 lead for Westington Springs. And sub Noel back in for Hitchcock Tuler. Next game is top seed of James Valley. Number 8 seed Will White. Pass in the corner to Kevin Allaps. And that's the three. And we'll go baseline, lean in, cut out by Linus. Back out, there's the three for Noel. Missed it, all hand, the rebound, but then lost it. Picked up by Tyrone Tedder. So the Spartans, there's another three for Tedder. That one short, long reach, and Tyrone will chase it down to keep it alive. The Westington Springs ball picked out of there by Johnson. As Noel picked the pocket of Andy, Noel down the floor, gets it into the way. Andy Noel with 6 points. As he picked the pocket of Andy Johnson and dribbled the length of the floor, went with the reverse layup. 14-11. There's the open three off the right side for Johnson. No good. Offensive board, Bridgman takes up. Good. Hardy fouls. Bridgman with a good ball take. He gets the defender up in the air, and then he's looking hard to the hoop. You hope to get your double figures here in the first quarter. 9 points for the freshman, Nathan Bridgman. The foul will be charged. Oh, let's see. second foul called in the game on Hitchcock-Schuler, just one on Lexington Springs. The foul will go on Nathan Peterson, his first. Free throw for Bridgman, no good. Long rebound out and will be tracked down by Hitchcock-Schuler. Peterson. Hopefully gets the ball back to Noel. 16-11 move for Lexington Springs. Pass in the middle, stall. Double team, getting 18 gonna go on the Spartans. 31.5 seconds to go here in the first quarter. And it's 16-11 in favor of Lexington Springs. Patriots run the out of bounds on their baseline. Ball kicked away, stolen by Lexington Springs. I believe Linus got a hand on that as they tried to lob it to Heisinger. They side open three. Now that's going to be a two out of zero because it didn't go in. Tyrell can't rotate that at all. Just put it up a little too strong. It's got two there, though, can't get the handle on the rebound, and Spartans will inbound it on their baseline. Right below me, pass comes in to Tyrell Tevenal. Converts it to Johnson, cross court, right side, high, open for three, right there. For the Spartans, they're up 19-11, with 16 seconds to go to go in the first quarter. So the Patriots just go ahead and keep things close. They can use a bucket here and try to close up the first quarter. Postman to Miller, top of the key, 6.5 seconds. Left side, it goes to Burton. He'll go inside. Heisinger leans in. He'll get fouled. The thing about Heisinger is that he's just going straight up with that shot. He kind of leans in, wants to draw that contact, and hope he can connect on the shot as well. He'll go to the free throw line to get a pair of free throws with 1.1 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Falls on Limus as the free throw is off the mark. No good. Is it Gorman or the team today, but teams have not kept their free throws very well here. Even yesterday with the girls, there were some struggles with free throw shooting. Isaac will try to salvage one shot here, and that one is good, so he goes one out of two. 1.1 seconds, and Devin Aldi with a long shot, and that's a buzzer, no good. At the end of the first quarter, Lexington Springs 19, Hitchcock-Schuler was pretty furious. Both teams were really moving it up and down the floor, it seemed like. Start the second quarter, and the Hitchcock-Schuler back. Leave. it. Comes high post, Clemenson. Clemenson has to Kevinall. He'll drive the paint. Bounce pass in the corner to shoot. Kevinall for three. No good. Rebound out. And Bergen has been ball out. And he's also over there by Bergen. Bridgman back into the game for the Spartans. 6:14 to go here in the first half. 22-12. Lexington Springs. Hitchcock Euler's offense is kind of bogged down here in the last couple of minutes of play. Kevin Hall is to take two Tyrell. Tyrell with it again in the corner. Tate. Kevin Hall with the attack. Baseline jumper. Too strong. Stall is no good. Rebound by Gepler. post, Brinkman. First round to Heim off the left wing. Heim, drive down towards the baseline, cut off, ball deflected, Clemens up. Oh, he didn't get lost, and he followed the ball was deflected. He picked it up, but it did step on the, or did land on the sideline, and Chris Osborne was right there to make sure that the officials did see it, and was in front of the Patriot bench. And then the Patriots a chance to cut the lead down to single digits here with 3.5 minutes to go in the first half. On the right wing, the pass goes down into the corner to Stahl. Now back up top, high finish, Heisinger. He'll lean in, double team, gets it out, baseline hole. Goes to the block, the short jump, and then go. Heisinger picks it out, ball controls. Keeps arriving inside the Heisinger, and boy, did he get hammered. He did the little ball fake, got Bridgman in the air, and Bridgman basically landed on it. Non-shooting foul, though, as Bridgman picks up the foul. That'll be the sixth team on Lexington Springs. Linus back in along with Kate Chevenard for Lexington Springs. Bridgman is his first. Pass comes in to Heisen again at the block. Takes a step, throws back. Copeland, he'll spot up. 14-footer, left side, no good. Rebound underneath. Foul put up too hard on the putback, saves it in. And a foul going to go on Heisen in the first. Now he's going to bring an opportunity. He's trying to have a decent look at that. Just going to get that putback together. And a little shove called on Brian Heisinger. Picks up his second personal 15 on Extract Relay. We have a timeout. Lexington Springs. Relay Boys Basketball Tournament. Second game of the day. And Lexington Springs up 10. 3 minutes to go in the first half. Richmond out on the left side for the Spartans. Backs in. Takes the shot. 18 footer. No good. Long rebound. Off track. Lost by Zephyr. These guys for Lexington Springs aren't afraid to go inside or outside. Richmond let that one fly. Barnes continues to hold pressure. All coming off left side. Those guys are screening each other off. Gets it across the line. That's fourth one. Sets it, comes off right side. No air on the wing. Miller looking down in the corner to Peterson. And over in front of the paint. Low free throw line gives a stall up the wing. And there's a travel foul in a center set by Stahl. And another one. He threw it back to Noel, but Noel came down the center pick and got away out of bounds anyway, so Lexington Springs gets it back. 26-16, Spartans lead. We call it Shakira leading early, although getting close there. But late in the first quarter, a little run by Springs got him up 7, and they've stayed up since. Down low, Linus with the turnaround at the block, and then blocked. And Richmond Seaway ends up being an air ball, and they work it into the front court. Gets a block, will get fouled, and go to the free throw line. We were going at this pace for a while in the first quarter where both teams are just really going at it hard. Not necessarily always under control, but we're definitely just trying to keep the intensity and the tempo up. And we're kind of seeing that sequence take place again here. Now Stahl with the free throw, no good. He's 0 for 2 from the line. Minute 52 to go here in the first half. Stahl's second free throw is good. He'll go in out of three. 5 points for Brandon Stahl. 26-17. The lead is down to single digits. And then back in is Zach Clemenson, I believe, for the Spartans. And well, Kevin Olive comes out with two Clemenson. He'll start to drive towards the paint. Lost the ball. Boy, he hit the floor hard. A little slow to get up. No problem. And to the right side, Burton. Burton driving out there closely. Now feeds back in the corner, Peterson. Back up to Burton, reverse around left side, Copeland. Stahl reverses right side. There's the open look hole. Passes up the three, goes into the paint. Off-balance 14 footer, no good. Rebound. That's going to be over the back on Copeland. Here's one of the foul. That will be team foul number 6. Gets back to there, so no bonus yet. Both teams will be bonus the rest of the way, but we only have 1:09 to go here in the first half. First foul of the game on Copeland. 26-17 Springs. The As we near the 1 minute mark here of the first half, Johnson up top. Rush run left side cut off. Pivot all feeds down low on the baseline to Clemenson. He's back out. Free throw line back up top. Johnson brought off the three. Now holds it for Tyrell Thibodeau. Gives to Tate in the corner. Tate uses the screen from Tyrell. No shot. Johnson back up top of the key. And he'll drive into the paint. Double team. Shoots over it. No good. But he's fired. And they throw it on the way for freshman Andy Johnson. Has not scored in the game. You'll get a pair here. Now, Beavers did a lot on offense here in the second quarter. Two shots from the field for Lexington Springs and one for Hitchcock Tuler. Free throw on the way and no good for Andy Johnson. And the free throws are hard to come by here as well for these two teams. Nobody's done a great job shooting free throws. They go back to the free throw. They back to 10, 27-17. Lexington Springs. Pass comes up the middle now. Pass off the left side. Burton and a throw in the middle of the line. Back into the game for your boys. We're down to 33.6 to go here in the first half. Iroquois awaiting the winner of this game to find out their opponent for Tuesday night's first semifinal. Thibodeau looks for a crease, goes into the paint, kicks out. They take Thibodeau for three. Picks up his second foul, I believe. And this will bring on bonus free throws for the Central Coast. And he scored here in the first half to shoot the bonus. That is the second on Thibodeau. .9 to go here in the first half. Free throw, no good. Rebound, Andy Johnson. That's for Westman to increase the lead. Johnson, three. Neither team scored here yet, so a 15-point lead will be the second call on Brandon Stahl. The first team here of the third quarter. Tate Thibodeau out there, gets the screen, drives into the paint. Off-balance shot, corner of the lane, no good. And Noel, and he's going to be fouled as he started to push the ball up the floor. And the team's been able to drop a shot here to begin the third quarter. Just played 44 seconds at this point. And to report pressure by Lexington Springs. A little looser than they were at the beginning. No Hall into the front court coming out to the right side. But it's down to the baseline. Ball knocked away by Bateson. Trying to keep it away from Heisinger. So the Patriots look like they are making a concerted effort to try and get it inside to their big deal, Heisinger and Stahl. Now comes in too. Knocked away. And Heisinger is going to be called, I believe, for a hit of the back. It was. They tried to rob it in the middle of the lane to Heisinger. In front, and then Heisinger was basically shoved in, try and get the ball, and Brian Heisinger picks up his third personal here early in the third quarter, staying on the floor for the time being as Hank Thibodeau comes up the left side, wasn't constrained, trying to increase the lead. Bridgman lost the ball, a sliding on the floor, and he's up by Stahl, and they're going to send a pitch back to her, so he's up by Stahl, got possession, and they use a 30-second timeout. 6:51 to go, third quarter, 32-17, Lexington Springs, 30-second timeout. 30-second timeout taken by Hitchcock Tuler, and Bartlett Stahl takes it down to the lane, and the foul is going to go on Lexington Springs. There will be a travel as Jason Kolosik up to question that call. It'll be Hitch got two air ball underneath the basketball, and Harlan Bergeline is his second. Pass comes in the middle, hiding it, hollers his way up, no good. Bridgman comes forward, and you can see the Patriots really trying to establish the inside game. Johnson's turn dropping right now. Kate Kevinall comes out, swings around the right side, Clemenson. He'll take a long three, no good. Long rebound, now he's going to catch up to it, normal trips it between Granite, and Kevinall has it in the backcourt. Stay with Lexington Springs. Now they continue to attach, but they start getting anything to drop right now. Lexington Springs runs the out-of-bounds play. Pass comes outside. There's the open three for Tate Kevinall. And they're going to get a rebound, and there's going to be a push. And that's going to go against Lexington Springs. Another team shooting the ball well. But still no scoring here in the third quarter. Fouls on Clemenson, and she is second. 18 fouls already in Washington State. We've had five fouls fouled up between the two teams. No points yet. Backcourt. There's a drive. Copeland gets around the double team into the front court. Stops on the lane. Gives to Noel. Reverse foul left side. All drives baseline. Can't slip it underneath. Noel comes high first. Hangs it up. He's down low stall. Powers up. No good. Good defense by Clemenson. Osborne off the Patriot bench, even like that call, but there's been a reach around on Washington Springs. Loud in the middle, Isaac got the block, through the hoop, missed it, gets the rebound up, and he's fouled. And finally, Isaac able to convert on the inside move. He's getting his own miss and put back. He has 3 points with a chance for the conventional three-point play. And the foul on Nathan Bridgman is his third foul. So, seen a lot of fouls called here in the early going of the third quarter. Free throw is no good. In and out for Isaac. 32-19. That was the first bucket of the third quarter for either team. And we have a whistle timeout. Washington scored here thus far in the third quarter, playing just over 2 minutes. Washington Springs off the out of bounds. Goes baseline. Open jumper on the baseline. Kate Tetterall is on good. Isaac goes high. All kicked out. By Bridgman, I believe, keeping that alive. Here's the drive in. Kate Tetterall. And oh! To the basket, leaned in, got bumped, and got the shot to drop. Acrobatic play by Tate Tevidal. First bucket of the second half for Washington Springs. Back up by 15 with a chance for the conventional three-point play for Tevidal. He had 7 points in the game. And as Kine comes back in for Washington Springs. Ball is, well, check that second. Free throw, no good. Offensive board for Clemenson. His shot won't go, rebound, and over the back. The shooting has been not very good thus far here in the third quarter. That foul was on Nathan Peterson. Now there's a foul called as well on Bergeline. That's his third. So fouls here rather rapidly in the third quarter. Looking back for it, can't get it to Noel. Noel pops out to the left wing, looking down low. Back up top, Heisinger. Lob goes outside to a Peterson off the glass too hard. Gets his first foul. Well, we haven't lacked for shots here. We just haven't been able to put him in the hoop. Hitchcock Tuler, 1 of 8. And let's see, I have Washington Springs, 1 of 9. The first free throw gives him 6 points. 34-19, Washington Springs, with 4 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Well, this game will play Iroquois in the semifinal on Tuesday. Second free throw is good. And as Copeland gets them both, he has 7. 34-21. 28 to go, third quarter. Into the front court, right side. thrown high on the right side. Now Thibodeau comes up, corner of the lane jumper is good. And Thibodeau has 6 points in the first half of the second half. He took 21, the lead back to 15 in Burton. And the game goes inside the stall on a reach in 5 and a goal against Lexington Springs. Other than Clemenson, really starting to pile up the fouls on the Spartans. Clemenson, Bergeron, and Bridgman all have 3 personal and already 16 fouls on Lexington Springs. We're barely halfway through the second or the third quarter. In the corner, over 3, Copeland in the corner. That's front of the rim, no good. Heisinger off with the offensive board. And Heisinger gets the put back in the lead of 13 now. 36-23, 3:40 to go, third quarter. Drive, and picked out of there by Hitchcock, too. On the front court, so Copeland, baseline, jumper, and he's fouled. They were on Heim or Limus as they were both kind of in a sandwich there on her. We'll get free throws here for Copeland. Copeland 4-for-4, shooting his free throws, has 7 points. Fouls on Alex Heim, that is his second. Free throw, front of the rim, no good. First miss from the charity strike for Heim. Miller back in for Hitchcock, too. Along with Nathan Peterson. And Kate Kevinalls back on the floor for Lexington Springs. Second free throw, Copeland missed them both. Missed four in a row, and then, there's Noel. I'm not sure what happened. He had the offensive board and then lost his footing, fell down, lost the ball, and was picked up by Lexington Springs. Up ahead, it comes to Heim, move all the way in. Saying it wasn't a foul, and just out of bounds off Lexington Springs, so no free throw here tonight. Oh, I see, no, this is the 15 foul. I'm all confused here. Now they have an official's timeout, and are they saying there should be a free throw? Yep, now they do figure it out. Okay, because I was completely confused, because I thought there was free throws coming up, and I just didn't realize it, but now they do have it figured out, and Brandon Stahl will go to the free throw line. I wonder if you're supposed to put time back up on the clock. That might be what they're discussing here. Well, I guess they're just going to leave it as it is. 2:38 to go here in the third quarter. Bonus free throw for Brandon Stahl. He's one of three shooting his free throws. And misses on that one. Rebound for Lennox. For Lennox. 2:35 to go, third quarter. Left side of the line, Lennox lost the ball, but a tip going to go on Hitchcock, too. This game is going to go on for a while. Both teams are approaching the bonus. In fact, 19 fouls now on Lexington Springs. That last one there goes on Hitchcock, too. And let's see who that last foul was on Hitchcock, too. I'll put it up on the board. There it goes. Brandon Stahl, that's his third. Out pass in the corner. Open three for Johnson. No good. Hall with the rebound on the weak side. Finally comes to Jim Barlow here, we're going to see it at some point. Yeah, 38 to go. Washington Springs trying to build on a 17-point lead. Open shot, corner of the lane, no good for Tate Thibodeau. And Huizinga has the board. So the team is continuing on pass. Bandit Burton on the baseline, goes back, open three for a hole. No good. Minute 16 to go in the third quarter, and Washington Springs breaking it open. As they're up 19, pending the free throw, Johnson hits it. There's 5 points here in the third quarter. 43-23, the lead is 20, with about 12 to go. Third quarter, Washington Springs on top. Left side, and there's going to be a blocking ball on Hollywood, and that would be number 4 on Alex. One thing Jason Kolosic's got to be aware of, and I'm sure he is. I've got a lot of guys in foul trouble. Hines has 4. I have Clemenson, Bergelin, and Bridgman all with 3.